Now we want to make this first page a title page. And I'm going to point out down here, we see this default. This is the current default style for our entire document. To make this first page a title page, we go into Format, Title Page. Here we want the number of pages, 1. And the first page properties should be first page. Going to use the rest all defaults, clicking OK. And we notice that our header has disappeared. Down here we see first page. Coming down, we see that this is page 2 of 8. It kept the page count. So what happens if we turn on our header here? Let's format page header. Turning this on, apply, OK. We don't see the header that we had on the rest of the document. Because this is a new section, we would have to give it a new header. Even if we want it to match the rest of the document, we still need a header for this section. So that's why there's nothing in there right now. It's a different section because we have this first page down here, and the rest is all in the default style. Let's turn off this header. Going to Insert, Header, and now we see the first page. I'm just going to check this to turn this off. Removing headers will delete the contents. That's okay, yes. So now we have our title page the way we want it. Our next page, we want to make this an index page. Right now it has default. We want to make this indexed. First thing we're going to try is opening up our style sheet. Going to dock it here on the side. Going over to the page styles. I want this to be an index, clicking the paint bucket, and we see the bucket, so we should be all set. I'll click it. We see this change to index. We still have the paint bucket, and let me hit exit to get out. Looks pretty good. We come down to the next page, and that says index, and all our pages say index. In fact, even our title page says index, so this is clearly not the way we want to do this. I'm going to undo to get out of this. We have our first page back. The way to get the index page is, let me turn on these non-printing characters, is to do it with the page break. I'm hitting the backspace so I see my table of contents. Now I'm going to insert manual break. We want a page break. The style we're going to change to index. We want to change the page number to 1 so the index has a separate page counter. Clicking OK. I'm going to add a footer to the bottom of this page. Insert footer. Now we've got a choice of our default page, our first page, or our index. I'm clicking on the index, page, and insert again, fields, other, page, page numbers, and we're going to make these little Roman numerals. Clicking insert, close, let me turn off this and zoom in a little bit so we can see how that looks. Zooming back out, I want this to be centered. So now we have our index page the way that we want it.